every time I edit these videos, I always think to myself, why don't I just take out the fucking trash bin from the shot every time? No one wants to look at a fucking trash can. Why is that always in the shot? Number two, how will you be able to tell us apart? I've said that joke before, but still, it bears repeating. Hi, how are you? Of course you know what this video is about. You clicked on it. The title is probably something very original and creative. Let me that's so raven it right now. Spoiler review on Call Me By Your Name. Something like that. It's not that, is it? That's cool. Honestly, if I were to enumerate all of my favorite moments of Call Me By Your Name, this would be double the actual length of the movie. So we're not gonna do that. As far as my thoughts in the movie go, I already went into it, and it's a non-spoiler review of the movie. There's a link to it in the description box. I was about to point over here as if I knew how to do that. There'll probably be a preview. There you go, that's a preview. Good job, Editor Noah, good job. If you saw my last video, then it's very clear that this is very much one of my favorite movies that has come out this year. So this video of spoilers is more so going to be about what moments within this movie had me either in tears and laughter, or a little hot and bothered, or all three at the same time. So, it's so hot! So fucking hot! Underneath the hairline. Let's proceed. Oh shit. Okay, so starting off, from the moment that the opening credits roll in, I'm done. The only other movie that got me this emotional during the opening credits would probably be Harry Potter. The entire aesthetic of it was so fucking pleasing to my eyeballs that I visually was stimulated and fulfilled. What I've never been sexually. I'm just kidding. Oh my god, I'm sorry, Mom. I am so fucking in. Sorry. Is that bothersome to you? I'm sorry. Another favorite thing of mine, and I mentioned this in my previous video, is the difference between book Elio and movie Elio. My opinion and how I saw Elio in the movie is, I love how in my notes it says this too. I wrote this like days ago and I still agree. Elio being a little shit. I enjoy it. Hashtag Elio being a little shit is one of my favorites. Right next to, like, it's right below horny Elio. These are my two favorite Elios. And then there's Elio going back and forth between French, Italian, and English. Because who doesn't love a polyglot? Not this bitch. What I mean by Elio being a little shit, and I promise you I mean this in the most loving way possible, is just the way that It's the way that he interacts with the people around him, with Mafalda first and foremost. I love that, the way that they bicker, and that was the time that Elio wanted to go out, and he was telling Mafalda that, hey, bitch, he didn't say bitch. He was like, hey, bitch, I won't be home for dinner. And then the interactions between Elio and his parents, love them, because he's so sweet towards them, but at the same time, it doesn't take away from the fact that he can still be playful, and you can see my sweat dripping. So when talking about Elio and how he is around his family, his friends, I obviously would also have to mention how he is with Oliver. And it has been said time and time again that their chemistry is so palpable and just real and organic. And while that remains true, I don't think that I can really fully express into words here or 10 years from now what it is really that is so special about the two of them on screen. This is something that's rare. In my opinion, at least, the couples that I enjoy watching and would watch them do mundane things like doing their laundry or talking about pockets or trying to microwave a burrito, there are very few of the list of couples that I love that I would actually watch doing these things. Elio and Oliver are one of those people. There are so many moments where a scene begins and ends where I wish it went on longer. Maybe that's more so in the end of the scene than it is the beginning, because I do realize that a lot of these scenes, they begin at the right moments. I don't know if that makes sense. But they do end sometimes rather abruptly, that it makes me wonder, oh wait, was that scene done? Because I wasn't done. Maybe it's a sort of tactic to make you feel as though you're watching something as it's happening, as opposed to watching a movie that's perfectly put together. So it added to this, the realism of it. And as Luca Guadagnino described, and I'd love to quote him on this because I loved how he described cinema, it's reality with a filter. It's just pieces of slice of life footage put together and then just thrust into the public being me, it's being thrust into me. Wait, no, stop. Another difference that I noticed in the book versus the movie, the first person perspective in the movie, they sort of deviated from that. But I like how we saw more of Oliver, even if it's just as a mirror of Elio, or at least in connection to Elio. I loved how Elio's parents were playing matchmaker the entire time. I liked how when they were speaking on the phone, Oliver admitted that he had an inkling that Elio's parents were kind of aware of their relationship because he felt like he was treated like a son-in-law. Like, shut the front door. I loved how there were a couple of lines that were very clearly spoken by Oliver in the book, and then in the movie, it was Elio who spoke them, and vice versa. The two moments that come to mind where this happened was the time that they were lounging about in what I assumed is heaven, and Elio was by a bench, I don't know what you call it, a side pool chair. I am cultured. We have Oliver just beautifully lying on the edge of the pool, looking gorgeous and golden as ever. And he goes, Elio, are you sleeping? And then Elio responds, I was. In the book, it was the other way around. Actually, someone correct me on this if I'm wrong, but I recall from watching this movie for the first time, when they meet at midnight and, you know, have a nice little wrestling match of sex, wasn't it Elio who said off and off and off? I think it's great because it plays into the whole theme of Call Me By Your Name and what it is to be in love with someone to the point of wanting to be with them and be them simultaneously. And before I forget, because I didn't put it on my list for some reason, the peach scene. So much better than I expected. It really, it's, oh my god. It was really good. I fucking love Tumblr. I think Tumblr's gonna make some amazing memes and jokes about this one day, and I will bask in all of its glory. So far, the people that I brought to see the movie and the people that I've spoken to regarding the scene have loved it. But I can imagine it being a rather polarizing scene. But if you guys have any thoughts, as always, you're welcome in the comment section. So leave a comment. I don't know what that was. That was just some tongue action that no one asked for. The negative shot, sort of like a dreamlike sequence that happens during their stay in Rome, it kind of felt like Elio was dreaming it up and thinking about it. But also, in a way, it was a shared kind of, I don't want to say flashback, but a shared thought or dreamlike sequence between the two of them, because they're so in sync and they've become one person. And while Elio was dreaming about it, you have Oliver that's thinking about it and being so deep in thought and so just sad. There is a simple sequence of scenes in the movie as well that I thoroughly appreciated. Oliver had agreed to meet Elio at midnight, and so throughout the entire day, you just see Elio going about his whatevers, right? He's like fucking transcribing music and then being a little shit, because that's what he does 24/7. Then suddenly he's like, you know, going down on Marzia. That's so Elio, just a typical Elio day. Always checking his watch just to make sure that he's within schedule. As soon as Oliver walks in, Elio doesn't give a fuck about this watch anymore. Fuck that watch. I'm done. He stands up. He's playing the piano, right? So he has his watch down here. He stands up because he sees Oliver and he's like, I'm so tired, like, I'm sorry, which is code for, like, I'm so fucking horny, I'm gonna get this dick wet. And his dad has to remind him that, Elio, this watch that you've been worshipping the entire day, don't you want it? And Elio's like, oh yeah, sure, I'll take it. Last thing that I'm gonna mention has to be Marzia, because there's no such thing as closure for Marzia in the book. She was basically treated as a slam piece and nothing more. This girl is so sweet and so earnest, and all she really wants is to love Elio and show him that he is worth love. And in return, Elio fucking ditches her night after night after night without a second fucking thought, and it's painful. It is so painful. The part of me is just like, God damn it, why didn't you just tell her? You could have saved her so much. Never mind. You should have just fucking told her, Elliot. Never mind. I'm good. I'm fine. Please go see it if you haven't. This movie is very important, and there are some incredible performances in it, and it's definitely worth your time. Bring your friends, bring your mom, bring your grandma. Maybe not. Not your grandma. Maybe your mom. No, wait. How old's your mom? No, never mind. And if anything, I hope you enjoyed watching this fucking review as well, or collection of ramblings regarding the movie. If you enjoyed this, I also have, I think, two other videos about Call Me By Your Name, and I do a bunch of, like, reaction videos to shows because I'm original, and yeah. So if that's the kind of content that you're into, subscribe! Why don't you? It's free. Also, I have all of my other social media handles listed over there, so if you want to follow me on that, I am on that, and we can talk about stuff. And you can send me nudes. Just kidding. Just kidding. I'm kidding. That said, if you have watched up until this point, thank you so much. My name is Noah, and you have a great rest of your life. I feel like that was good. Like, that was much better than the rest of the other stuff.